At the helm of this custom chopper shop is a phenomenon known to millions of Americans as Paul Sr., a man whose old-school wisdom commands respect.
Hey, I don't want to ask the same thing twice. The second time, I'm going to use my foot.
Because I'm going with a reptile theme for my bike, it's important that it's fast. That's why I ordered a special engine for this bike. It's exactly what I need to give it the quick cobra-like speed. I gotta admit, working on this bike makes me feel young. I can't wait to drop the engine in the bike and watch Paulie's face turn green with envy.
Hey, where'd you get this wicked thing?
I thought you might like that.
I like it, all right. I don't think a man your age knows what to do with it. You sure you know how to handle this bad boy?
All right, punk. Time to set the record straight and show you I still got it in me.
With his reputation on the line, Paul Sr. comes out of retirement to construct a bike sure to make the competition's blood run cold. Paul Sr. gets to the get, wasting no time to create a menacing force with a mighty bite. Will Sr.'s venomous creation top his POW tribute? See if the old man has still got what it takes.
Everything flows. Everything's beautiful. Beautiful. Doesn't do anything for the bike. Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
Yeah. way off.
You know, Mikey, always griping about being the errand boy. So I thought I'd give him a little test and get him accustomed to some real responsibility and whatnot. I put Mikey in charge of ordering a fender for my bike. And you know that saying? Never send a boy to do a man's job. Mikey, this is a clutch. Tell me, how do you confuse a fender with a clutch?
To the human ear, they sound exactly the same.
I tell you, I'd blow a gasket if I had the time, but it's late and the parts stores are about to close, and if I don't get the tail on tonight, I've lost a day. I'll deal with Mikey when I get back, and in the meantime, he'll rake the gravel driveway till the cows come home. I'll admit it, I'm a perfectionist. There's no two ways about it. I like a clean shop and people that know what they're doing. Hey, in my world, it's my way or the highway. When this nut called me and told me my transmission was never shipped, I went ballistic. I tell you, my blood pressure went right through the roof. But Paulie gave me a dose of my own medicine. He told me I didn't have time to cry about it. I have to say, when he said that to me, something happened inside. I got all fired up. I thought, when have I ever quit? It ain't in me to quit. So instead of letting this bozo burn my chops, I'm getting to the getting and searching this town high and low for a transmission.
What the hell did you do to this thing?
Like most geniuses, Paul Jr. is often misunderstood. What exactly is fabrication? It's an art, a precise science, and one can't be bogged down by trivialities, but rather embrace the nature of inspiration.
Doesn't do anything for the bike. Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
I hate to admit it, but my father has some good advice. Before making some of the hottest made custom choppers, he worked in the steel business for 30 years. He knows what it's like to work hard and build from the ground up. Truth is, if anybody knows anything about how hard these guys work, it's my father.
Get started right away.
In my book, that goes a long way.
I need some inspiration.
You're asking me for my ideas? Did you fall and hit your head? Look, get your butt out to a real site, get a feel for the work and the machines, and you'll get inspired.
We'll be right back.
One of the pleasures of creating a custom bike is taking it out for its maiden voyage, full throttle on the open road. But none of this would be possible without the men and women of the highway construction crews. This is the reason behind Paulie's tribute bike. With limited time, Paulie must create a tough, fearless, American original.
Everything flows. Everything's beautiful, beautiful.
For this bike, I need a special carburetor. Something with some giddy up. Now it's up to me to find one, and find it fast. Vinny suggested I contact the new parts dealer down the street. But when I called, right off the start, me and this guy had a bad connection. Now I'm on my way over to see if I can get this carburetor. working. What does it look like I'm doing?
It looks like you're chit-chatting over there with Vinny when you should be working on your bike.
We're discussing the design of the tank. Relax, will ya?
No, I won't relax.
Here we go.
Why do you always do this? I just don't understand your lackadaisical attitude. Listen, just get it done. Now.
You know, in designing, it's important to communicate effectively. Because I wanted to make sure that this tank had a tough industrial look for this bike. Vinny and I had to talk about ways it could be done. But my father gets all bent out of shape if he thinks you're screwing off. And frankly, I wasn't in the mood for it.